brings all this integrity to play without ego, and it's rare, believe me.
She caused multiple generations of cooks, I'll say at this stage, to understand that this can be as good as anywhere.
So trickle down of her initial work, her journalism, her teaching, her standards, her emphasis on the authenticity, the provenance of the food, the artisan producers. She's really a champion of the local producer and of the authentic. And I think there are many, many people indebted to her who don't even know her name.
She thinks, I think that she's just doing it all on quite a small scale, but it's absolutely bigger than anyone realizes, even her.
That's really the big message of Myrtle. Is respect the soil and let nature's bounty, you know what I mean, arrive to your table.
Since 1964, she has articulated this very passionate, generous, sustainable ethic of working, cooking, farming, and being.
I think learn as much as you can. Really. So, I mean, I went to the School of Commerce as soon as I left school and did cooking and dressmaking there. And the art school where I wasn't ever going to shine. And I think it says go and get experience. I remember thinking I'd like to have a whole series of experiences behind me. Traveling, going to places, knowing about things. And I would say go and learn everything you can because it'll always come in useful afterwards. And watch other people and just listen to them. They might be right, they might be wrong, but just listen what they say.
If you work very hard and if things go wrong, it's very heartbreaking and there's no satisfaction. If you work very hard and it's success, there is satisfaction. But apart from that, I do get enormous satisfaction in being able to give people the food that I think we ought to be eating.